This is the Bearcat Sports Network. It's time for Sam Houston State University Bearcat basketball. 101.7 KSAM has every dribble, swish, and squeak from buzzer to buzzer live. Now let's head down to the floor with the voice of the Bearcats, Rob Hipp.
All right, friends, a pleasant good afternoon and welcome to another edition of Sam Houston Men's Basketball on the Bearcat Sports Radio Network. So glad that you could join us here today as we are live at the Super Pit. On the campus of North Texas University, it is the Bearcats on the road facing Division I UNT. Set for a good one here versus the Mean Green. This is a Mean Green team that is coming off back-to-back Conference USA championships. They also had a NCAA tournament berth last year, of course, after winning the Conference USA. And they won to Purdue in that opening round of the tournament and then lost after that. Should be a good one here today. And again, I want to welcome you into the booth. I'm Rob Hipp. As we are moments away, tip-off going to happen here in about 13 minutes or so. Well, we'll go back up briefly. Sam Houston fought to the end, but a rocky start in the first half was too much to overcome. And that 78-73 loss to UTSA at the Toyota Center on Saturday, the Bearcats in that contest trailed the Roadrunners by 18 in the first half. They got back into the game, though, in the second half on a 7-2 run. DeMarcus Lampley got Sam Houston within four with a three-pointer to make it 61-57. That was at the 8:06 mark. And then Savion Flagg, the Texas A&M graduate transfer, eventually tied that contest at 63 with a three of his own, only to see UTSA respond in a 9-0 run. A three by Lampley once again pulled the Bearcats within 76-73 in the closing minutes. The Roadrunners, though, they were able to put the game away at the free throw line. Lampley led Sam Houston with 23 points, and Flagg finished with a double-double, 19 points and 13 rebounds. J.D. Ray, we've called his name a lot this season. He scored seven, and then Tristan Ipe had 8 points and seven rebounds. The graduate transfer, Savion Flagg, he had a career-high 31 points and grabbed 11 rebounds. In the Bearcats' 74-65 loss at Nebraska, he has scored in double digits in all eight games that have played this season. Sam Houston, of course, playing in the new conference in the WAC for only 1 year. They will move to Conference USA next year. And for North Texas, they are moving out of Conference USA and heading over to the AAC. So a lot of changes. That all stemmed from Texas and Oklahoma earlier this season, of course, moving from the Big 12 to the SEC. And that has really caused a windfall throughout the college world landscape. But for Sam Houston on the basketball side, going to be a great move for them. Well, a win today for North Texas would improve the Mean Green's winning streak to four in a row. They have three in a row right now entering this contest. Their longest winning streak all of last year was five games. They accomplished in the postseason with four wins in that 2021 Conference USA tournament. And then they went on, as I said earlier, in the first round of the NCAA tournament, defeating Purdue. A win today for the Mean Green would also improve their record to 6-3 on the year, despite the back-to-back Conference USA champs. It'd actually be their first or their best nine-game start to a season since the 2018-19 season when they begin the year 8-1. UNT started last year at 5-4. They started the 2019-20 season at 3-6. Well, Grant McCaslin, he's one win head coach, one win shy of moving into sole possession of fourth place at UNT coach wins. He enters this contest tonight, 84 wins here, and tied with Jimmy Gales from 1986 to 93 for the fourth most coaching wins in program history. Thomas Bell heads into Tuesday's game, 4 points shy of 600 career points. The third-year UNT forward will be the seventh UNT men's basketball player to score 600-plus for fifth-year head coach Grant McCaslin. And then also a name that we're going to call a lot tonight. This is a young man standing at 6'10", the sophomore forward, Abu Usman. He has played 159 total minutes so far this season, 37 minutes away from surpassing his season total of all of last year at 195. So again, set for a good contest here this afternoon, and thank you for joining us as we'll turn it down to the public address announcer and our country's national anthem.
Coach Grant McCaslin, welcome to the fabulous Super Bowl for tonight's matchup between the San Houston State Bearcats and your North Texas Mean Green.
Well, here in just a few moments, here we go, here with the national anthem.
As we celebrate our freedom and those who protect it with the singing of our national anthem, tonight the national anthem will be performed by Ms. Mia Steen.
So proudly hailed.
It's a beautiful rendition of our country's national anthem. I had a chance to catch up with head coach Jason Hooten a little bit ago. We'll step aside and take a break. We'll have that interview when we come back. This is Sam Houston Men's Basketball on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Sam Houston Athletics would like to thank the following partners: Sam Houston Alumni Association, Art Tech Signs and Lighting, Aspen Heights, Barefoot Campus Outfitters, Bill Fick Ford, and Chicken Express. Thank you for supporting your Bearcats.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Rob Hipp here pregame with head basketball coach Jason Hooten. As we quickly look back, talking about UTSA on Saturday. Coach, down 18 in the first half, but your team fought back, tied it at one point, just not able to hold on in that ball game. Savion Flagg and both DeMarcus Lampley in double figures in that game. Lampley had a great night shooting from behind the arc. Just your thoughts on that game.
Yeah, I mean, it was a disappointing loss. Obviously, we got off to a really bad start. I thought we kind of came out flat for the first time this year and just really weren't ourselves to begin that game. And then, you know, sometimes when you dig yourself that big of a hole, it takes so much energy and effort to get back, and you know we did, but you know it was also one of those games where we never took a lead, and you know you just kind of felt like at one point where if you just ever got ahead by one or two points that you'd find a way to win that game, and you know and just gotta keep getting better and just gotta find a way to bounce back tonight here at North Texas.
Today, game 10 of the season facing North Texas on the road in Denton. The Bearcats 9-17 all time against the Mean Green. The last matchup was back in 2016. Coach, got a day to travel, came up last night. Things were pretty relaxed, but this team's ready to go. Talk about this one heading in today.
Yeah, it's a team that's a lot like us. We have a lot of similarities, I think, you know, as far as style of play. I think both teams hang their hat on defense and toughness. And, you know, and then I think we play a lot of ball screen motion like they do as well. And so, I think sometimes, you know, when you look at a team like this, I think it'll just basically come down tonight to who can establish their style even more. And they're a very good team, though. Obviously made the NCAA tournament last year and won a game. Got a lot of guys back from that team, and you know, it'll be a great challenge for us tonight. You know, I was just sitting there thinking this afternoon in the hotel room, you know, we've only had one Division I home game, and you know, it's been a tough schedule for us, but I do know that it's going to pay off.
Coach, where do you feel that the team is starting to improve, you know, starting to get a little bit better from behind the arc? What are some other areas that you feel that they're improving?
Well, I think the behind the arc thing is just basically getting familiar with the offense. And I think like every year, you know, you're just trying to understand your roles. I think guys are starting to figure out that, you know, where they fit in, you know, offensively, defensively, just, you know, that typical where's my role and, you know, what role do I need to play on this team? And, you know, I think probably the UTSA game, the thing I was most disappointed in is we didn't play defense like we've been playing all year long. You know, I think giving them 78 points, I think they shot 47% from the field. And, you know, we got to get that percentage down defensively as a team. And then also I think we're giving up way, way too many threes at a high percentage, which we normally don't do. So we've got some improvements to make for sure. And, you know, we'll have to do that tonight.
Some of that may spill over. Now it's time for Coach Hooten's Keys to the Game presented by Emblem Properties Real Estate. Coach, keys to victory in this one tonight.
Yeah, I think first and foremost, you know, we've got to do a good job of defending them and, you know, limiting their easy baskets. You know, they're a team that, you know, thrives on getting the ball to the paint and driving and kicking and shooting open threes. Again, a lot like ourselves. I think we just have to establish our identity tonight and, you know, in our toughness early in the game and, you know, in that defensive presence. I think the second thing is they're a really, really, like us, a really, really good offensive rebounding team. So we've got to continue to offensive rebound, but tonight we've got to block them out and, you know, keep them from getting second and third shots. And then I think the last thing we have to do tonight here is, you know, we've got to limit threes. You know, they're averaging almost 10 threes a game, I think, right at 10 threes, 8 or 9, something like that. And we've got to do a good job tonight of limiting their threes and, you know, and keeping them from getting those offensive rebound putbacks and those easy baskets off of those missed threes.
Awesome, Coach. We appreciate you. The keys to the game brought to you by Emblem Properties Real Estate, who offers the customer service difference for our clients, our number one. Coach, as always, appreciate your time and eat them up, Cats.
Eat them up, Cats.
Let's wrap up our pregame with head coach Jason Hooten. We'll have more in-depth looking into this one tonight from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, Cats.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays, with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
All right, friends, back at it from the Super Pit here in Denton, Texas. We are moments away from tip-off, and here is your Sam Houston Bearcats starting lineup for tonight.
Turnaround jumper here, Tristan Igbe starting early, and the Bearcats take a two-point advantage. Find Lampley from the corner, weaving through traffic, the jumper, the two-shot, the yes! There it is to Marcus Lampley for two. Turn on the light. Over to Jaron Cook for three. Light the stove, baby! It's Jaron Cook, and the Bearcats are on fire here in the first half.
He pulls it back down, though. Oh, what a play by Javion May as he hauled in aggressively the offensive rebound and dropped it back in off the right side of the glass. Dante Powers, zing, zang, bang. There it is for two. Oh, call dancing with the stars. We got a new celebrity on the court. It's Dante Powers.
Hey, Sam, I can dance just as good as you guys on TV. I do it on the basketball court.
At guard, a 6'7", 215-pound grad senior from Texas A&M University, number one, Savion Flagg.
At guard, a 6'2", 195-pound junior from Chicago, Illinois, number 11, I'm Javion May.
At forward, a 6'6", 225-pound senior from Deer Park, Texas, number 12, I'm Tristan Ebert.
At guard, a 5'10", 165-pound junior from Midwest City, Oklahoma, number 13, I'm Jaden Ray.
At guard, a 6'2", 175-pound senior from Phenix City, Alabama, number 3, I'm Light 'Em Up, DeMarcus.
So once again, your starting lineups for the Sam Houston Bearcats. It is Savion Flagg, DeMarcus Lampley, Javion May, Tristan Ipe, and Jaden Ray for the University of North Texas. The Mean Green tonight on their home court here at the Super Pit in Denton. They'll start things with a 6'2", 180-pound first, a senior guard out of Augusta, Georgia. It is number one, Martez McBride. A 6'6", 205-pound forward senior out of East St. Louis, Illinois, and Kaskaskia Community College number four, Thomas Bell. A 6'1", 180-pound graduate guard out of Rowlett, Texas, and Eastfield College number 11, J.J. Murray. And a guard, a 6'9", 190-pound sophomore out of Houston, Texas, Jack Yates High School number 15, Reuben Jones. And last, but certainly not least, for North Texas, the Mean Green, it's a 6'10", 230-pound sophomore forward out of Brooklyn, New York, and a Scotland Institute, it's number 33, Abu Usman. So once again, it is McBride, Bell, Murray, Jones, and Usman for the Mean Green. As we are just a few moments before tip-off here in this contest, Sam Houston already huddled up, and the Mean Green looking at the video board right here at the Super Pit as they're showing their introduction video. We'll go back a game for this North Texas team as they were victorious over UMass 66-57. North Texas defeating UMass at the Basketball Hall of Fame Classic at Dickey's Arena on Saturday afternoon. The Mean Green handed the Minutemen their fifth loss of the season, improving to 5-3 on the year. Coach McCaslin said he's proud of how their team battled in that contest, doing a good job attacking the paint and playing team defense. It's a great team who can shoot the lights out, so we knew they were always in it. Proud of how we stuck together today. In that contest, it was a balanced scoring effort by the Mean Green with seven student-athletes scoring in the first half. Reuben Jones was on fire early in that first half with eight of his own, going 2-for-4 from three-point range. The UMass zone couldn't slow down UNT's offensive attack as Abu Uthman had dominated the paint, reaching double figures early. And that is one that we'll have to keep an eye on here. Watching team video with Sam Houston, they talked about Uthman getting down inside the paint and able to turn around. One thing that he does very well, he hauls in a lot of offensive rebounds and second chance points. There is quite a few left-handers on this UNT team as well. Sam Houston has prepared for that. So be on the lookout for a lot of these players to drive to the left and try to lay it in off that left side of the glass. Well, for Sam Houston, of course, their last contest, as we talked about earlier, versus UTSA at the Toyota Center on Saturday, the Bearcats lost that contest 78-73. They'll try to rebound here in this one and get a much-needed victory versus the Division I program. North Texas Mean Green 5-3 in the Conference USA under head coach Grant McCaslin. He's a Baylor alum from 1999, 84-54 in his fifth season here at North Texas, 39-29 in 5 years at Conference USA, and overall his sixth coaching season in Division I at 104 wins and 66 losses. He's been a head coach, though, at the collegiate level for 8 years, 160 wins and 78 losses. For your Sam Houston Bearcats, 3 wins, 6 losses in this early season. Under head coach Jason Hooten, the Tarleton State alum from 1991. In his 11th season at Sam, 219 wins, 153 losses, and still yet to start WAC conference play. I said earlier, only 1 year in the WAC. They will play 2 years in the WAC conference, Sam Houston, before moving to Conference USA. Hooten in the Southland went 127-67 from 2010 and 21. And again, overall in his 11th season, 219 wins and 153 losses. Mentioned earlier, this Mean Green team, back-to-back Conference USA champions. And for UNT, in every game this season except number 4 Kansas, North Texas has led with 6 minutes remaining or less. Their current 3-game winning streak, they're holding opponents to an average of 48 points a game. North Texas on a 13-game home winning streak against teams from the state of Texas. And so tonight, Sam Houston going to try to upset that. The Bearcats onto the court now in their orange jerseys, orange shorts, Sammy the Head logo on the left pant leg, the triangle logos of gray and white on each opposite end of the short pant leg as well, the numbers in white outlined in gray with the Bearcat paw logo on the back. Numbers in white, Bearcats written across the front with the numbers in white. For the home team tonight, North Texas, they are in their gray jerseys and gray shorts. The trim is in green with the UNT logo on the short leg. Names are written across the back in green. The numbers are in green, outlined in white, and North Texas is written across the front of the jerseys. As both teams onto the court now, standing out there is Savion Flagg at center court. And he is joined at the circle by Abu Uthman. And so here we go, folks. As the opening tip, the referee Rick Crawford throws it in the air, and the Bearcats control the opening tip. As we'll go from right to left, Sam Houston moving, and it's Jaden Ray over the right wing up top over to Tristan Ipe, left-handed dribble, as he'll rotate over the left wing, bounce pass down low over to Savion Flagg, trying to work from the circle in the paint, throws it up and a travel here and a turnover by the graduate transfer from Texas A&M. It's not how Sam Houston wanted to come out of the gates. Coach Hooten is livid on that first performance there by Sam Houston as they turned it over right away. UNT will inbound the ball. They'll move from left to right. And the ball goes out of bounds here, and North Texas will bring it right back in. Thomas Bell on the sideline here. Across, trying to inbound the ball, goes over to McBride. McBride guarded by Jaden Ray. Ray showing some backcourt pressure. As McBride brings it into the front court from left to right on the far side. Working a right-handed dribble, drop pass over to Jones. Jones with the right-handed dribble at the top of the three. He'll go back over here to Bell on that left wing. Bell guarded by Savion Flagg, back into the hands of Usman. Usman, quick bounce pass over to Jones. Jones will zing this one over to the left wing. Three-pointer, it's not there. And the rebound falls into the hands of Sam Houston. So Murray put up a three, it wouldn't fall. Here come the Bearcats on their second possession. It's Jaden Ray, finds some light, finds Javion May from the right wing. May, bounce pass over to Ipe. Throw it up and in for the big fella, Tristan Ipe. And the Bearcats are on the board first, leading 2-0 with 1 minute gone here at UNT. Mean Green bringing it from left to right. It is Reuben Jones guarded by Ray, working off the high screen on the right wing. Now the step up is DeMarcus Lampley. Lampley now guarding Bell, who received the pass. Bell trying to work from the circle. Straight away three on a pass. This shot off the back of the rim won't fall. High up into the air, Savion Flagg. And here come the Bearcats. One on two as Lampley slows things down. Over to the left side on the near side. Bounce pass from Savion Flagg up top to Ipe. Ipe, one left-handed dribble. Chest pass over Savion Flagg. This one rattles in and out from three-point land. And a hard foul here on Javion May as he was trying to haul in a rebound. And a little bit too aggressive there for Javion May. So that is May's first personal and the first team foul for Sam Houston here in the first half. As Mean Green will inbound, it's Bell on his own end of the court. Two in the backcourt for Sam Houston. May is back there alongside Flagg, and now Bell will bring it into the front court. It's stripped by Javion May. He'll go up top here to Lampley. Lampley over the left wing to Savion Flagg, trying to work from the baseline. He'll find May, right wing three on its way. This one off the back of the rim, and the rebound falls into the hands near that left corner, left elbow by Reuben Jones. Jones has it here, back over to the right side for the Mean Green. Now a left wing over to Murray. Murray, quick chest pass goes to Bell. He's still out there at the left wing. Trying to work inside here on Savion Flagg with a right-handed dribble, backing him down to the keys. He'll turn around here. Nice little reverse layup. That shot won't fall, but the offensive rebound by Usman. He'll throw it up. It's partially blocked, but Tristan Ipe called with the foul. That's what we talked about going into this ballgame. Usman is going to take a lot of second-chance opportunities. You've got to box him out. Unfortunately, there on that play, though, Ipe charged with the foul. That is his first personal and the second team foul by Sam Houston. So Usman at the line here. 10 of 20 this season from the free throw line. The first one is on its way and good out of the right hand. So that's the first point of the night for the Mean Green, trailing 2-1, 17:35 to go here in the first half. Usman's second free throw, bends his knees, right-handed delivery, rattles in and drops. We're tied two apiece here. As the Bearcats have it on the near side, moving from right to left, Jaden Ray will bring it across the Eagle logo at center court with a right-handed dribble. Now to the right wing. He is picked up on the defensive side by Murray. Finds Ipe at the top of the three. Ipe near the left elbow. He wants to go in on the baseline to the left side. Picks up his dribble back over to Javion May as he was double-teamed. May with nine on the shot clock. He'll find Savion Flagg way out there from 28 on the right wing. Here's Ipe, straight away three. This one bounces out, won't fall, and a rebound skyrocketing into the air for UNT is Murray. And now the Mean Green inside. Usman thought about it, kicked it back over to his teammate for a three, and that one is good. McBride able to nail one from that left corner. And UNT has their first lead of the night, 5-2, 16:45 to go in the first. Sam Houston quickly back to the left side as Jaden Ray calls Ipe for a high screen. Near that right wing, now a left-handed dribble, rotates over Javion May. He'll take a right-handed dribble from the right elbow, trying to feed Tristan Ipe, and it's turned over. Now on the court is Murray. Murray, though, able to find his teammate. Now they'll push it into the front court. Here's Bell. He thought about a three from the right wing. Now tries to work inside with Marcus Lampley guarding him. Now a straightaway three on the pass. This one nowhere close on that from Reuben Jones. Bearcats trailing 5-2. They've got the ball on the far side, moving from right to left. Over to Savion Flagg. High screen Ipe. This ball's poked away, and it's turned over. Good defense there by McBride. It's 2-on-1. The assist, McBride and his teammate got the shot off the left side of the glass. Good move there. And that shot dropping in for UNT. That was Bell coming up there. 7-2, Bearcats trailing by 5. 15:50 to go here in the first half. Lampley gets this one stolen by Murray. Murray 1-on-2 from left to right. He'll pick things up. Now finds Jones on the right wing. He's guarded by Savion Flagg. Jones, no dribble, just quick pass over to the corner. And now inside to Usman. They'll turn around on Javion May off the right side and one. Oh, baby. As he had a nice step there and able to turn that one around, and a foul on Sam Houston. And that will take us to our first media timeout. We'll step aside and take a break. We'll be back in a moment from Ben Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
Back at it, friends, from the Super Pit in Denton, Texas, at Sam Houston men's basketball, trailing UNT on their home court 9-2, 15:33 to go here in the first half. It's a 9-0 run to start this ball game for North Texas over the last 2 minutes. Sam Houston has turned it over three times in the last 3:30. They haven't scored in that time as well. The only one on the board is Tristan Hipp, who is 1-for-2. Bearcats only shooting 1-of-4. That's an area that they've got to pick up on the shooting side. Coach Hooten wants to see these guys shoot over 45% per game. And so far in this contest, struggling out of the gates early. This is a Bearcat team that averages just under 73 points a game. UNT at 67 per game. So if you look at things on paper, it's a pretty evenly matched turnout here. But Sam Houston, again, they've been struggling against Division I teams this season and trying to turn that around. But it's a hard one with a 13-game win streak on the line here at home for North Texas. As we come out of that timeout, an and-one opportunity coming up here for Abu Usman. He's already made two free throws, and here's his and one from the right hand. This one rattles in and good. And Amin Green now in double digits, leading by 8, 10-2, 15:30 to go here in the first half. Devon Grant will check into the game for the first time tonight. It is Grant, Flagg, Lampley, Damon Nicholas Jr. also out there in Ipe. As Grant has it on the left side, trying to work a dribble inside off a high screen from Ipe, now rotates over the left wing. He'll pick up the dribble to his belt line, pass to Savion Flagg, who's trapped, now up top to Ipe. Ipe, quick pass back over to Grant. Grant floats one up. This one bounces off and no good. And that ball went out of bounds. Looked like off a UNT player. Wow. It looked like from here that it went off the hands of Jemiah Simmons. And I believe the umpire here, Amy Bonner, went over to talk, and she turned it over. She saw it. And that's the right call there for Amy Bonner. Tristan Ipe will head over to the bench. He'll get a high five from Coach Hoot and Coach Bailey and the other assistants. And Sam Houston will get another opportunity here. Javon Grant inbounding on the E of the Mean Green logo on the baseline. Up top over to DeMarcus Lampley. Right-handed dribble. Crossover. Straightaway three. This one won't drop. And the Bearcats are cold from downtown. 0-for-4 now after they shot very well from three-point land in that loss to UTSA. Back the other way. The Mean Green take a three. And that one is easy. Does it there for Mardez McBride. McBride will take him as he has jacked up 50 of them this year. Not very good percentage, though, at 28%, but he's made another one here for the Mean Green. They're leading 13-2 as Nicholas Jr. floats it up off the right side. That shot isn't there, and another rebound here for Jemiah Simmons. And here comes UNT from left to right. It's Perry. He'll go over to the left corner. Bounce pass, dribble goes back over right wing. Perry, he'll take a three. That one off the back of the iron. And Sam Houston's Cooper Kowalski could not hold on to the rebound, and it's another offensive board here for UNT. as Jones has it at the top. Double team. Savion Flagg, Lampley on him. Little give and go hot potato from Scott back over to Jones. He'll find Scott. Scott over to the corner. Here's a three by McBride. Good. And now it's 3 of 7 from three-point land. McBride has all three of those three-point shots. He's got 9 to start this game, and it's a 16-2 North Texas lead. We'll step aside. We'll take a 30-second timeout from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays, with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp from the Super Pit in Denton, Texas. Bearcats trailing North Texas 16-2. It's a 16-0 run over the last 3:30 for UNT. They have made 4 of their last 5 shots, and the Bearcats trying to put an end to that drought. They've got to score here on this possession. And Javon Grant has it on the far side from right to left, and he turns it over. He was trying to go to Kean Scroggins, and Scroggins is charged with a foul as he was reaching in there on Jemiah Simmons. And boy, Bearcats cannot catch a break here. We'll see who that's called on. Well, that foul was not on. Yeah, they're going to call it on Kean Scroggins. Finally came through. That's the third personal for Sam Houston and the first for Kean Scroggins. 16-2. Bearcats in a hole here early. 13:50 to go in the first. UNT has it moving from left to right. It's in the hands of Perry near the left wing. They'll try to drive baseline. Now picks it up just outside the keys. Pass quickly over the right corner and back over the right wing to Scott. He'll take a three. This one no good. And Kean Scroggins trying to come in on a rebound. There's bodies all over the floor. And we've got a foul here against Thomas Bell. So the foul there on Thomas Bell, that's his first personal.
That is his first personal foul.
And that's the first team foul for North Texas as well. Bearcats have turned it over 4 times in the last 5:30, trailing 16-2 after taking the early 2-0 advantage. Damon Nicholas has it back for Sam Houston. Now into the hands of Dante Powers, who checked in moments ago. Over to Lampley, left wing. He'll take a long three, and he's hit. The shot won't go down, and Lampley, for the first time this season, will be rewarded with three free throws coming up here on the left wing. That's something DeMarcus Lampley's known for. He hasn't been able to draw them this season. I believe that's the first time that Lampley has drawn 3 free throws. He's a magician working a lot of and ones on 3-point plays. Lampley, only 4 of 6 this season in 9 games, a 67% free throw shooter. Here on the left side, as he'll take a few dribbles, spins the ball in his left hand, right-handed free throw shot on its way off the front of the rim, no good. And boy, that is an area that Sam Houston has struggled from free throw land this season. As Lampley misses the first one. One more coming up here for Lampley, or 2 more, makes the next one. So 16-3, that will finally end that scoring drought of over 5 minutes and 40 seconds. Savion Flagg will check out of the ball game here for Sam Houston. Ipe back in. It's Scroggins and Ipe down in the keys. Lampley shooting the free throw. Made the second one, missed the first one. He's got one more coming up. He'll take a few dribbles from the right hand. And now that right-handed free throw shot, it's no good. So only 1 of 2 for Lampley that time. Or 1 of 3, rather. And the Bearcats trailing 16-3. North Texas back over to the right side. It's Usman. Double team Jones. Jones down to Usman, just outside the semicircle in the paint. Flips it back up, and here's a shot. And boy, and one coming up here on a late whistle. No, wait a minute. I think Kean Scroggins took the charge. So Kean Scroggins. Yeah. Nope, it's a foul on Kean Scroggins. And I'm not sure here why there wasn't an and one. Scroggins got charged for the foul. And that's his second personal. No free throw, though, on an and one. I don't understand that. Sam Houston has it back to the left side. It's Ipe over Lampley, losing the handle, throws it up in the air. Scroggins going for it, and it goes right back to Usman. 18-3 the score, 12:30 to go here in the first. Here's a three from the right wing, and that one is buried at the bottom of the net for Reuben Jones. Amin Green are hot right now, 21-3, 12:26 to go in the first. Bearcats in a huge hole. Dante Powers has it over the left side, behind the back dribble, back up top over to Lampley. Lampley, one-on-one matchup with Jones, now double-team. Bounce goes over to Scroggins. Scroggins picks up his dribble, thought about a shot from the free throw line, trying to feed it down low to Nicholas, and it's turned over. And we got a jump ball, and possession arrow will go to UNT. Well, the Bearcats here, seven turnovers in the last 7 minutes. They have not made a basket from the field in 7 minutes as well. We'll step aside on a 30-second timeout by UNT. We'll be back in a moment from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
The Bearcats have turned it over six times in 7 minutes. They have not made a field goal in that same time. Oh, of their last six, and they trail UNT here on the road in Denton, 21-3. Sam Houston only 1 of 7 from the field, shooting 14%. They are 0 of 4 from downtown to start this game. And Lampley with his three free throws, only made one of them. One free throw on three attempts at 33%. On the flip side for UNT, they're shooting hot here. 7 of 13 from the field at 54%. 44% from downtown. They are 4 of 9 from three-point land. And a perfect 3 for 3 as Usman has made all of his free throws. Bearcats again have turned it over seven times and one for UNT to start this ball game. Once again, I want to welcome you into the broadcast booth. Thanks for joining us. Reminding you that our Bearcat fan text line is open as always. You can text us at 512-522-9105. Again, that Bearcat fan text line is open. Let us know where you're listening from tonight and who you're cheering on. 512-522-9105. And if you're on our social media feeds in the booth, you can also send a comment. We'll get to those as this game goes along. Jonathan Knobloch joining us as always, saying let's go Bearcats. Dave Richardson saying let's get mean with the green on our Facebook in the booth feed. And my wonderful mother north of Austin in Georgetown saying good evening from Georgetown. Love you, Mom, and thank you for tuning in tonight. As we'll whistle back into play here against Sam Houston, Lampley, Nicholas Jr., Ipe, Powers, and Scroggins on the court for Sam Houston. And for North Texas, it's Bell, Perry, Murray, Jones, and Usman. And we'll whistle back into action. Players heading back. And after the turnover here, UNT will have it. And inbounding for North Texas is Thomas Bell. He'll stand in front of his own bench in his own backcourt on that corner baseline on the near side. Bell trying to get it in. Bearcats have four in the backcourt. As they do finally get it in, Jones will bring it here from left to right. He's got to hurry. And he does make it across the timeline and just in time. North Texas back on it on the right side. Ball goes up top to Bell. Bell quickly back over to Perry. Perry feeds down low. Usman as he's backing down Kean Scroggins. That's his play. He'll turn around, float it up, hook shot, and one. Got to stop that guy. We talked about this heading into this ball game, and Usman now with 7 points and another and one coming up. He's 3 of 3 from the foul line. He's got a chance to take this. Already a 20-point advantage, 23-3. He can make it 21 on another made free throw. 11:46 to go here in the first. And Scroggins already has three personal fouls. It's the 14th foul by Sam Houston. Actually, check that. It's 15 fouls now for the Bearcats. Damon Nicholas Jr. charged for one earlier. So here's Usman for the and one. Off the right hand, this one won't fall. Savion Flagg with the rebound. Here come the Bearcats on the near side from right to left. It's Jaden Ray back over to Flagg. Top of the three, left-handed dribble. Works in the paint, floats this one up. Good for Savion Flagg. And that will stop the 23-1 run as the Bearcats were scoreless over the last 7:27. And here comes UNT back on the far side from left to right. McBride He'll work his dribble on Dante Powers to the right wing. Now zings this one from the left hand over to Bell near the left wing. Bell guarded by Flag, trying to work from the left elbow now. As he'll back down, Savion Flag on the second key. Picks up his dribble. He's double-teamed. That leaves McBride wide open. Right wing three won't fall. Usman tipping the ball and could not haul that one in as it went into some fans on the sideline. And it will go back to Sam Houston. The Bearcats trailing 23-5, 10:59 to go. As Aaron Scott will check into the ball game. He's a 6'7" freshman forward. He'll check in for Thomas Bell, the senior. Scott played in 8 games so far, all 8 of them this season. Averages 5 points. And he is a 50% shooter from the field. Averages 15 minutes a game as well. Bearcats have it on the left side. It's Ipe at the top of the three. Handoff over to Powers. Powers from the left wing. Wants to work inside the baseline. Now kicks this one out of the Ray. Savion Flag straight away. Wide open three. Way too strong. But Ipe pokes it right back over to Ray. Ray will float one in. That shot good for Jaden Ray. That was all set up by Tristan Ipe with tipping that one back out. So Ray with the basket, 23-7. UNT with the lead on the far side. McBride back over to the right side. It's into the hands of Jones, guarded by Ray at the top. The high screen was coming from Usman. Bearcats trying to turn it around. They've got it. It's a wide open. Savion Flag slam it down as Jaden Ray made that happen. And the Bearcats coming alive here in the first, trailing 23-9.
Timeout going to the series.
We'll step aside and take a 60-second timeout from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Hey, y'all. Josh Ward here for Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville. If you want a real truck that looks good and that can pull any load, do what I did. Decide the options you want and go see No Bull Bill. You'll spec out your order and agree on pricing and then leave the rest up to Bill Fick Ford. You trust them to build the Ford truck of your dreams and they'll trust you to buy it. No deposit required and you still get a No Bull deal. It's buying made easy. Bill Fick Ford, your No Bull headquarters. Check them out online, BillFickFordHuntsville.com.
Welcome back, friends. Actually, that was just a UNT timeout. And so we're back at it here. 23-9, Sam Houston on a 6-0 run after they were scoreless in over 7 minutes. Now on a 6-0 run of their own in the last 1:30. Trailing 23-9 with 10:07 to go as we're halfway through the first. North Texas has it. They'll move from left to right. Right-handed dribble brings it into the front court as Jones guarded by Dante Powers. Jones to the right wing. Good defense here by Powers. Jones picks up his dribble over the head pass to Perry. Perry will flip this one over to McBride back at the top. 10 on the shot clock. Perry guarded here by Nicholas. Wanting to work is Perry inside. Turnover, Damon Nicholas. How about that for Nicholas on the defensive side? And here come the Bearcats. Savion Flag on the near side. Crossover dribble. Puts one on his knees. Boy, there's a player out there. He shook down a player and his ankle is injured. Jaden Ray straight away three. This shot isn't there. And the Bearcats trying to fight for the rebound. They've got it. It's in to Savion Flag and one. As Nichols saved it, threw it to Flag, and the Bearcats on a roll. There is an injured UNT player, though, down on the court. It's Tyler Perry, and Perry rolled his ankle as Savion Flag sent him to the court. A little shake-and-bake move a few moments ago, and hopefully he'll be okay in this one. You never want to see these young men get hurt. He's a 5'11 junior guard and their best free throw shooter on the team too at 88%, where he's 23 of 26. One of their leading scorers as well with 13. You hate to see that for UNT. Savion Flag at the line. He has struggled from the line this season where he's only a 31% free throw shooter, 10 of 32. He'll try to take advantage of the and one opportunity here as the Bearcats trailing 23 to 11. He'll take the free throw. This one is good for Savion Flag. And the Bearcats now on a 9-0 run of their own of the last 2:30, trailing 23-12 with 9:22 to go here in the first half of play. North Texas will bring it over to the right side. Trying to work down is Reuben Jones. He'll find Bell on the right wing, guarded by Flag. Right-handed dribble, crossover to his left hand. Trying to work his way down inside the paint from the circle. Now kicks it back. Around the world we go. This ball up top here to McBride. With 5 on the shot clock. Turned over. Bearcats have it again. It is Dante Powers as he falls, finds Nicholas over the back. Shot's not there. Ipe striking in, but it goes out of bounds. And boy, the Bearcats defense have really turned it on now with three turnovers over the last 3 minutes by UNT. As Nicholas will head back over to the sideline, Coach Hooten has his right arm around his shoulder, having a chat with him. And Nicholas will get a high five from assistant coach Mudge and Bailey down there as well. 23-12, 8:48 to go here in the first half. Bearcats trailing on the road at the Super Pit. North Texas has it. It's a steal by Powers, and he's all alone, lays it up. Good for Dante Powers. So now four turnovers in that last 3 minutes. Dante Powers able to capitalize. The Mean Green have it back on their side on the right side of the court. Into the hands of Jones. Jones will find Bell on the left wing. Trying to drive inside here. Savion Flagg reaching in. Now McBride, corner three, yes. Boy, he has been hot from downtown now. 4 of 6. McBride has 12 points in this ball game. And that will stop the four-minute drought. 26-14, Bearcats trailing. Jaden Ray thought about driving in, loses the handle, but Flagg is there on the left wing. Flagg, Ipe setting up a high screen, and sends it over to Powers, way out there at the top of the three-point line with 10 seconds on the shot clock to Javion May. May, the left-handed dribble. He'll find Savion Flagg from the corner. Step back three. This one won't fall. Rebound, May. And Ray will, Javion May will put it up. It's not there. It bounces around, but his second effort as he puts it back in off the front side of the rim. Good second effort there by Javion May. Bearcats trailing by 10, 26-16. As the Mean Green have it here, moving from left to right. It's Reuben Jones, works off the high screen from Bell, floats this one from near the right elbow, shot's not there, but the offensive rebound back over to UNT. Here's a three from the left wing. That shot won't fall for Jones, and here comes Javion May, left side, yes, for Javion May. It was a beautiful feed by Dante Powers. As the Mean Green will bring it back into the front court, crossing the timeline at center. It is Jones over to the left wing. Aaron Scott, the freshman forward, over the right wing. Now to Reuben Jones, back up top. The ball goes around into the hands of Scott. Scott will find Bell. Bell inside the paint. Tough shot, not there. And the Bearcats have the rebound. Powers over to Savion Flagg. Skip, dip, shot's not there. Rebound May, putback's not there. No foul, but it goes out of bounds. And the possession will stay with Sam Houston on a 15-3 run over the last 5:09. We'll step aside on a media timeout. We'll be back in 2 minutes from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Our Tech Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp here live from Denton, Texas. Bearkats on a nice 15-3 run, capitalizing on four UNT turnovers over the last 5.5 minutes. And Amin Green's lead has been cut to 8, 26-18. After they had a 20-point advantage earlier in this ball game. And again, Sam Houston taking care of it. Was 23-3. So how about this run for Sam Houston right now? Forcing a lot of turnovers. And the Bearcats trying to get back into this ballgame. They've also improved on their shooting, now 8 of 20 after they started the game 1 of 7 from the field. However, they have not made a shot from downtown so far tonight. Versus UTSA, they went 10 of 23 from that three-point line. Or beg your pardon, they were 15 of 35 from the three-point line in that contest. So far tonight, only 0 for 7. They'll try to find something from behind the arc as well. As the Bearcats inbound here, it's Ray over to Javion May on the right corner. Quick pass goes over to Scroggins, back over to May, and now the pass on the right wing to Jaden Ray. Handoff over to May. Left wing, it's Savion Flagg with 5 on the shot clock. He jacks up a 3. This one off the side of the rim. Won't go, but the rebound poked around, and Jaden Ray has it. Back over to Flagg. Left wing 3. This one no good. Boy, the Bearcats cannot find a shot from behind the arc as they are now 0 for 9. Sam Houston, though, pokes this one away. It's another turnover. It's 2-on-1. Flip, alley-oop, slam a jam, a mama, baby. What a play by Dante Powers over to Savion Flagg. It is 26-20. On the alley-oop, and now back the other way. This ball is knocked out of bounds, and Sam Houston will get it right back. 17-3 run over the last 6 minutes for Sam Houston. They have got the energy here, trailing 26-20, 5:41 to go in the first half. As DeMarcus light him up, Lampley back onto the court for Dante Powers. Jaden Ray will inbound under his own baseline on the E of the mean green. Here's Lampley, jacks up a shot, won't fall, poked up into the air, and the ball into the hands of North Texas. As they have not scored in 2:30 and 6 turnovers in the last 6 minutes. It's Bell has it on the right side, guarded by May, trying to cut that angle near the paint. Now from inside the circle, throws up a shot. It's not there, but the foul is on Kean Scroggins more than likely, and that is his fourth personal, if so. They're only showing one up there. They're only showing Kean with two fouls. Yeah, well, Kean Scroggins, they're only showing him on the board with. That was a second foul. I thought for sure he had more than that earlier. And for Sam Houston, that is 16 fouls, though. So Scroggins actually only has 2. And at the line here is Thomas Bell. Bell bends his knees. Free throw shot on the way. Bounces in. And good for Bell. He's a 77% free throw shooter. 27 of 35 on the season. And averages 13 points a game. Another one of the top leading scorers on this team. Made the first free throw here on the right side. He'll have another one. As the umpire, Amy Bonner, bounces it into him. Here's the next one. This one on the way. Not there. And Ipe has the board at the free throw line. Here come the Bearcats, trailing by 7, 27-20. 5:16 to go here in the first half. May has it way out there on the right wing. Right-handed dribble. He's got a lane on the baseline. Swings it over. Ray thought about a three. Finds Lampley. Lampley inside now near that right baseline. Picks up his dribble. Back up top over to Ray. Ray inside the paint. Slicing, dicing. Finds May. Wide open three. This one isn't there. The Bearcats 0 of 10 from three-point land. You have got to be kidding me. As Javion May was wide open. It's not like these threes have been contested. The Bearcats have been open on almost every one of them. 27-20. Mean Green with the lead, and it's knocked out of bounds. And the Bearcats will get it right back after another forced turnover. That is 8 turnovers now by UNT, and the first one by Bell. Javion May will inbound just in front of the scorer's table. Coach Jason Hooten had some words in his right ear. The inbound pass in the backcourt goes to Jaden Ray, now bringing it to the front court on the far side. He has it near that right corner. He'll find Lampley. Lampley trying to weave through traffic, picks it up, finds Ipe, the assist, the shot, good for Tristan Ipe off the DeMarcus Lampley assist. picture-perfect basketball, 27-22. Bearkats within five now, trailing 4:13 to go here in the first. Almost another steal. UNT, it is a steal. As the Bearkats force the turnover. Up front to May, spins around, hits the deck hard, and hopefully Javion May will get up as, boy, he went inside, did a little 360 and came down hard right under the rim into the mat. And he is down there. And luckily there, Javion May hops right up. Boy, that's a scary moment when one of your best guys goes down that hard. And luckily for Javion May, he'll pop up. Just a little stinger there for him as he'll head to the free throw line. 4 of 6 this season, 67% in 9 games. Javion May's got to find a way to start scoring as he only averages 5 per game. I believe we've got a timeout on the court. We'll take it for 30 seconds from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
COVID-19 rapid testing is available at Texpress Urgent Care in Huntsville. No symptoms needed. So now you can get tested even faster and get your results back faster too. Limited shots are left. Not sure which test is right for you? Texpress Urgent Care is happy to help. For more details, call 936-570-2626. No appointments needed. Walk-ins only. Texpress Urgent Care Clinic, located at 193 I-45 South. Check their website at TexpressUrgentCare.com and visit them on Facebook. That's Texpress Urgent Care, next to Sport Clips in Huntsville.
Back at it, friends. Before that break, it was a personal foul against Abu Usman. That was his first personal. And only, yeah, his first personal there for him. And Sam Houston will have it here. That's only the fourth team foul by UNT. So Javion May at the line to shoot two here. 4 of 6 this season. Bends his knees. Right-handed free throw shot won't fall. Once again, an area that Sam Houston has struggled with all season is from the free throw line. Missed the first one, takes a deep breath, yellow sneakers on. Here's the right-handed free throw shot. This one no good either. Aaron Scott able to haul it in, I believe, there for UNT. No, that was not Scott. Bell has it on that right wing. Now the ball into the hands of Perry. At the top of the three, guarded by May. Bearcats with the pass going over now to the left corner. Bearcats double teaming. Now they switch to one-on-one. As Usman, turnaround jumper. That one not good from just outside the paint. Good defense, Ipe. Here come the Bearcats. Jaden Ray over to Flag for three. This one is no good, and the Bearcats' three ball is not falling tonight. 27-22. UNT with it on the right side. They haven't made a field goal now in 5 minutes of play. North Texas has it. Perry at the top, over to the left elbow, drives inside, picks up his dribble. He'll find J.J. Murray from downtown. Not there. Bearcats weren't even close on the offensive rebound. They didn't box out. That ball fell. Usman pass goes and one. Wow. Perry found Usman down low, had an easy shot, and he was fouled, and he'll have and one. That'll take us to a media timeout. We'll take 2 minutes as the Mean Green, after almost 6 minutes, finally find a shot from the field, an and one, leading 29-22 with 3:07 to go. We'll step aside and take a break. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, y'all. Josh Ward here for Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville. If you want a real truck that looks good and that can pull any load, do what I did. Decide the options you want and go see No Bull Bill. You'll spec out your order and agree on pricing and then leave the rest up to Bill Fick Ford. You trust them to build the Ford truck of your dreams and they'll trust you to buy it. No deposit required and you still get a No Bull deal. It's buying made easy. Bill Fick Ford, your No Bull headquarters. Check them out online. BillFickFordHuntsville.com.
3:07 remaining here in the first half. Bearkats at one point trailed by 20. They have cut it as close as 5. It's now been extended back to a 7-point mean green advantage, 29-22. And an and-one opportunity coming up here for Abu Usman after he has made his presence known with 9 points here in this ball game, 3 of 4 from the free throw line. He is a 50% free throw shooter entering this contest. He was 10 of 20. We'll have another opportunity here on an and one from the right hand. This one rattles in and out. Boy, it hung on the rim there on that left side. It just would not fall in. Savion Flagg picks it up, and now we go to Jaden Ray. Ray brings it in the front court from right to left. Over to Lampley, now left wing. Flagg finds Nicholas. Nicholas from the left baseline. Back up top, Lampley. Good ball movement here to Ray. Ray from the baseline. He'll flip it over to Ipe. No foul was called. Ipe was manhandled, it looked like, from here. But, man, it's just been good defense for UNT, and it's turned over. So that'll go right back to North Texas here. Again, holding on to a 7-point advantage, 29-22. 2:43 to go here in the first half of play. On the far side is Perry from left to right, guarded by Ray. Perry now near that left wing as he works off of two defenders that were on him. Ipe stepped up and he was able to work through it. Still has it here as Perry now rotates to the right wing. Perry from just inside the right baseline. He'll flip it all the way out to Jones. Jones puts up a shot. This one is good. He actually found Usman down low and he dropped it in for 2. 31-22. Extended it back to a 9-point advantage. Bearkats have not scored in 2 minutes now. Ipe has it on the left side. Over to Flagg, left-handed dribble. Flips this one to Nicholas. Back over to Flagg. And now the pass back to Nicholas. Goes down low, Ipe. Ipe from the left elbow. Inside from the circle. Off the left side of the glass, too strong. Fighting for his own rebound. Nicholas has it. That shot way off the mark. And Ipe, jump ball, and Bearkats. Oh, they're going to get a possession here to North Texas. So Sam Houston not able to hold on to that one. Jump ball, possession arrow will go to North Texas, and Tristan Ipe will head over to the bench. He'll get a standing ovation from his teammates and coaches as Dante Powers checks back into the ball game. Usman heads over to the bench as well. So it is Flagg, Lampley, Nicholas, Ray, and Powers on the court for Sam Houston. McBride, Scott, Bell, Perry, and Jones for North Texas. Perry has it near the left elbow, guarded by Powers, and Powers a little reach-in foul here, and Bearkats have already put UNT in the bonus, so they'll have 1-1 coming up here. That's good, by the way, for Tyler Perry to be back into this ballgame. Remember earlier, he rolled his ankle, and luckily he's back in it here as one of their top scorers. You're going to put a man at the line. It's not him. He shoots 88%. And Perry still looking for his first points of this ballgame, though. He normally averages 13. Here's the first free throw on the front end. It's good, so he'll be rewarded and have one more. It's back to a 10-point North Texas advantage. Sam Houston pulled to within 5. The Bearkats, one of their last 7 shots. They haven't scored in 3 minutes. One more free throw coming up here for Perry. On that right side, bends his knees, right-handed free throw. Good, makes both of them. So again, UNT in the bonus now. Bearkats with 18 fouls as Sam Houston brings it into the front court. Jaden Ray, 1:34 remaining, trailing 33-22 in the first half. Ray has it on the left wing from Flagg. Ray floats this one up. Good at the bottom of the net for Jaden Ray, just inside the left elbow. Nice floater there for Ray. And that'll stop that scoring drop for Sam Houston. 33-24. North Texas with the lead. 1:15 to go. They've got it on the right side. It is Perry trying to work a crossover dribble. Works around a high screen on that left wing. Powers hits the deck there. Perry thought about a 3. Now flips it over. Inside. Finds his teammate. This one up. Blocked out. Man one. Wasn't blocked. J.J. Murray able to bounce it in off the left side. With 7 seconds on the shot clock and an and one coming up here for Murray. A foul was on Nicholas, his second personal.
That is his second personal foul. And at the line now for a possible three-point play. Number 11,
and the Bearcats here now with 9 team fouls. An and one is good there for J.J. Murray. 36-24, 1 minute straight up to go here in the first half. Jaden Ray, center court, brings it up front, right-handed dribble. Guarded up top by Murray. He'll find Flag at the right wing. Flag has Jones on him, trying to work from the free throw line. Step back jumper, good for Savion Flag. Boy, the Bearcats needed a shot from the field. They got it there from Savion. Back to a 10-point advantage, 36-26. 32 seconds remaining. Bearcats will be able to take the last shot here as UNT will jack up a three from the corner. That shot nowhere close, and Ray not able to save it. It goes right into the hands of a UNT player, but a foul here called against Sam Houston. J.J. Murray, the ball went right into his hands as Jaden Ray was trying to save it.
That's on Sam Houston's number 24, Dante Powers.
That one's called on Dante Powers. That's his second personal. And again, 10 team fouls, 2 free throws coming up here for J.J. Murray. Murray with 5 points, 1 of 1 after he made the end one just a few moments ago. Here's the first one from the right hand. This one rattles off the right side and ricochets out of the rim. Again, 36-26, 20 seconds to go. North Texas, the Mean Green leading, trying to make it 14 in a row on their home court. Murray will bend his knees. This delivery on the way. This one, no good either. Boy, it ping-ponged and battled its way outside of the rim. Missed both of them. Here comes Sam Houston. Game clock is off, shot clock at 10. Jaden Ray has it on the left side. Down to 6. Ray's got to work here. From the left hand and a reach-in foul called against the Mean Green. And that foul on J.J. Murray. It's his first personal. And the 17th foul here. Actually, the 15th foul here by North Texas. 4.4 remaining as Nicholas will inbound for the Bearcats on the left side. He's got to get it in. He'll find Lampley. Lampley turned it over. And at the buzzer, a three-point shot. This one is not good. McBride jacked it up. The Bearcats trailed by as many as 20. They cut it to within 5. They'll head into the locker room at halftime, trailing by 10. 36-26. We'll step aside. We'll take a break. Carlos Zimmerman back at the flagship. We'll have a nice halftime show for you. For now, though, let's take a break from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grill to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
101.7 KSAM and the Bearcat Sports Network welcome you to the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. Now let's go back courtside with Rob Hipp.
And a pleasant good evening, Huntsville, Texas. At halftime here between the North Texas Mean Green and your Sam Houston Bearkats, 36-26 the score, right here on the flagship 101.7 KSAM. I am Carlos Zimmerman. Thanks for joining us for the Bearcat halftime show. Man, it's been an up and down kind of game so far tonight for Sam Houston, and the reason being is that UNT got off to quite a hot start. If you were just joining us here this evening on 101.7 KSAM, UNT, North Texas, got off to a 23-1 run start after Sam Houston had led 2-0. And just, I've never seen anything like that before, folks. It's incredible. I've never seen a team do it like that to start a game. I've seen it late in games before, but not like that for UNT. Sam Houston shot 14% to start the game, 1 of 7, and had 5 turnovers in the first half of the first half, 0 for 4 from deep as well. Bearkats, however, turned it into an 11-0 run when they were down 23-3. That made it 23-14 off of several turnovers by the North Texas Mean Green. That totaled out to 8 turnovers up to that point. Run finished for the Bearkats at 19-4 in favor of the Cats. As Rob said, the Bearkats were able to cut the lead down 2-5, but it has grown since then. And a big part of that as well is because of the and one opportunities that North Texas has had so far in this one. I mean, I've been trying to keep a tally back here at the station and just cannot believe how many opportunities they have had. A lot of those buckets coming on and one opportunities. With the score at 36-26, this is the 6th game of the season that Sam Houston has been held under 30 points in the first half. So some things are going to need to change in that second half, and we'll go over some keys to pulling off a victory in Denton tonight coming up in the second segment here on the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. Time to take a look at some stats for both Sam Houston and North Texas. For the Bearcats, individually, Savion Flagg's got 11 points. He's 5 of 12 from the field, 0 of 6 from behind the arc, 1 of 1 from the charity stripe. Not a big sample size, but that has allowed him to gain some confidence from the free throw line. He entered tonight 31% from the free throw line. 4 rebounds for him as well, plus 2 turnovers. DeMarcus Lampley, just 1 point so far on 2 shots taken. That 1 point coming from a free throw where he is 1-for-3 when he was fouled outside the arc. 1 rebound to his credit as well, plus an assist. Damon Nicholas Jr., not much so far as he has seen only 10 minutes of action. Jaden Ray, doing well after being added to the starting lineup a few weeks ago. He's at 4 points. He's 2 of 3. He's got 2 rebounds as well, plus 2 turnovers. And then Dante Powers, he has 2 points as well. Looking at some other players that have made an impact so far, Tristan Ipe, 6 points, 3 of 6 from the field, 4 rebounds to his credit, plus 2 fouls and a turnover for the big man Ipe. And that is it for points-wise for the Bearcats. On the other side, for North Texas, it has been a heck of a start for 2 of their players. Mardrez McBride, he has 12 points, 4 of 6 from the field, also 4 of 6 from 3 land. That's all he's taken tonight, ladies and gentlemen. That is why they are so hot from 3 at the moment. Looking further along as well for UNT, another hot start for their big man in Abu Osman. He's got 11 points, 4 of 5 from the field, 3 of 5 from the charity stripe. He's got 2 rebounds, plus a steal as well for the big man. Also getting some action out there for UNT at 5 points to start this one so far, as J.J. Murray had a fall to the floor earlier in the game. Glad to see he's still up and going. 5 points, 2 of 4 from the field, 1 of 3 from the charity stripe. Looking at the team stats across the board, Sam Houston at 38%, 12 of 32 from the field. The big thing, though, for the Bearcats, 0 of 12 from outside the 3-point line. Need to fix that if they're going to claw their way back into this game. They're also 33% from the free throw line, 2 of 6. 10 turnovers for the Bearcats. UNT has been able to get 12 points off of those turnovers. But again, the theme for the Bearcats, it's been winning the rebound battle at 22. 48% shooting for UNT, 12 of 25. They're 36% from 3, 5 of 14. They're 7 of 12 also from outside, at the charity stripe. They have 9 turnovers as well. getting 12 off those turnovers, but the 10 for the Bearkats on the points off of the UNT turnover. 17 rebounds for the North Texas Mean Green. Sam Houston's got 9 offensive rebounds and 4 offensive rebounds for North Texas. Again, halftime here on the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show, 36-26. North Texas leading the way right now. We'll step aside and take a break. When we come back, we'll look at keys to the second half as well as take a look at the college basketball scoreboard. Stay with us from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcat Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Welcome back on the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show, final segment here. Before we get you back to the Super Pit in Denton, Texas, and Rob Hipp, again, your score 36-26 between the North Texas Mean Green and the Sam Houston Bearcats. Real quick, here's some keys for the second half for Sam Houston. Really, the big key is the three needs to be found. 0 of 12, like we said, from three-point land, and that's not going to get it done. Someone's got to get it going. You need your sharpshooters to get going. DeMarcus Lampley, he's had a quiet night. Savion Flagg knows how to shoot the three as well. Got to get those guys going. The other thing, win the turnover battle with North Texas. They're doing that, almost doing that right now. Kind of dead even. 9 for North Texas, 10 for Sam Houston. Bearcats 10 points off of those 9 turnovers by UNT. The other thing, make your free throws. It sounds like a broken record every time you hear it, but you got to make your free throws. They're 2 of 6, 33%. From the charity stripe, something they need to fix, not only in this game, but going forward through the rest of the season. And then limit the fouls as well. North Texas finished that first half in the double bonus, so you got to avoid making more mental mistakes down the stretch here in this one to claw their way back again down by 10. Time for the college basketball scoreboard in the Western Athletic Conference. Stephen F. Austin is at home in Nacogdoches right now. They are welcoming in the ULM Warhawks, the Warhawks leading 55-48. Tarleton leading over South Alabama right now, 32-28. And then Texas Southern and UTRGV just got underway, 11-8 lead for the Tigers right now over the Vaqueros halfway home in the first half. If you're a North Texas fan listening in around Conference USA, Louisiana Tech up on LSU Shreveport, 61-48. UAB leading over Grambling, 63-35 with 9.5 left in the second. Western Kentucky is up 48-18 on a T3 school. Don't quite get who this team is. Anyway, Jacksonville, they are up 29-19 on Southern Miss at the half. And then just a couple top 25 games going on right now. Duke well in control, the number 2 team in the country, 60-27. LSU won earlier tonight as the number 19 team in the country, 89-49. The University of Texas takes on Arkansas Pine Bluff starting just now over in Austin. And the game to watch tonight, if you're a top 25 fan, Alabama is on the road at Memphis. That's going to do it for the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. We'll get you back out to the Super Pit and Rob Hipp in Denton, Texas momentarily for the second half of this one between North Texas and Sam Houston. So stay with us. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcat Sports Radio Network.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
This has been the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. We'll be right back with the second half of tonight's game on the Bearcat Sports Network and 101.7 KSAM.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
All right, friends, welcome back. Rob Hipp here in Denton, Texas. North Texas Mean Green tonight on their home court battling Sam Houston. The Bearcats only shooting 37% from the field compared to 48% for the Mean Green. Bearcats have 8 steals, 9 for UNT. No block shots by any team in this first half of play. The Bearcats also turning it over 10 times. The Mean Green with 9 turnovers. Sam Houston, though, out-rebounding UNT 22-17. 9 of those on the offensive side of the glass. And we will see if they can get things rock and roll. Sam Houston, historically this season, has always been a better second-half team. They trailed versus UTSA by 18 on Saturday. They came back and tied that game in the second half. And we'll see if a little bit of a spark during that halftime for Sam Houston. See if they got a spark to get them back here in this ballgame. 1 point, as you heard from Carlos back on the halftime segment just a few moments ago. That's a new feature that we'll try to have here for every game. So appreciate Carlos and his work back at the flagship. Sam Houston got it to within 5, but then stretched back out. Now at a 10-point deficit, 36-26. So we'll start things back on the court for Sam Houston. It is Savion Flagg, DeMarcus Lampley, Javion May, Tristan Ipe, and Jaden Ray. And for North Texas, they'll go back with McBride, Bell, Murray, Jones. And also, they have brought Usman out there as well. So both teams with their starters. Sam Houston will inbound to get this one started here in just a few moments. It's Savion Flagg has it. Over to Jaden Ray, and second half underway here in Denton, Texas. Jaden Ray up top over to Javion May as the Bearcats will now go from left to right. The basket on the right side of the court. And we'll find Lampley in a turnover here, though, as it's a foul on the offensive side against Sam Houston. Boy, tough break for the Bearcats. Called on Tristan Ipe, and that's his third personal and the first team foul of the second half. It's one thing that Sam Houston's got to be careful of. You don't want Ipe to get into foul trouble. Now a 3. And just like the start of this game, too, Sam Houston tried to run an offensive play, and it resulted in a turnover. So not the way they wanted to start the second half. UNT will have it here. They'll move from right to left on the far side. It's Perry trying to work from that right wing. High screen up there by Bell. And Savion Flagg is guarding Perry. Now back over here to Bell. Trying to work on the right baseline from a semicircle. Boy, Ipe got a hand on it. Jump ball, possession arrows. Sam Houston, I believe. Great job there by Tristan Ipe. And no, that possession arrow is going to stay with UNT. 11 seconds on the shot clock. North Texas will inbound on the left side under their own rim. Trying to get it in. This one will go up top over to Usman. Usman on the right corner. Pass goes to Perry. Now into the hands of McBride. He'll find Jones. Jones goes up top to Bell as the shot clock expires, but the offensive rebound there, Javion May wasn't able to block out. Goes to Jones. Jones feeding Usman down low. Scroggins on him. Turnaround jumper not there. And Savion Flagg hauls it in off the right side of the glass. Here come the Bearkats from left to right. It's Jaden Ray. High screen. Scroggins. Ray, as he wiggles his way inside, that shot won't fall. And we got a foul on the court here against North Texas. As the umpire, A.B. Bonner, calling the foul. And let's see if that one went on possibly Bell. Not sure here. Yep. It's on Thomas Bell. And for Bell, that is his first personal and the first team foul here of this second half. Sam Houston inbounding, trailing 36-26. 1 minute gone here in the second. Ray over to Scroggins. Good assist, but Scroggins thought he was wide open, missed the shot, but Javion May there with the rebound. Here's Flagg from downtown. Rolls in and out, won't fall. Bearkats have not made a three. They are now 0 of 13. That is tough for Sam Houston. Back the other way, a foul here as Thomas Bell was going in off the left side. And we'll see if this one's on Lampley. Lampley may have got a hand in on it. Yeah, it is. First personal foul for DeMarcus Lampley and the second team foul for the Bearkats here in this second half. Sam Houston trails by 10, 36-26, 18-38 to go here in the game. It's Thomas Bell shooting free throws. First one, good. Right at the bottom of the net, he is now 2 for 3 from the charity stripe with 4 points here in 18 minutes so far this evening. It's Lampley and Javion May change positions down in the keys. Flagg and Scroggins down there as well. Jaden Ray will stand at the top of the three. Here's the next free throw. This one off the front of the rim, and Savion Flagg, boy, looked like slow motion as he hauled that one in, extending his arms. Here's Jaden Ray to the right side as he slipped and dipped his way inside. The shot wasn't there, and a foul here against UNT as Javion May hit the deck. It was a block there on Usman. But the foul is called here on UNT. Bearkats inbounding. Over to Kian Scroggins from Jaden Ray. And Ray has it back on the right wing. Up top, Scroggins from the paint. Drops it off. Savion Flagg over his back, trying to lay it in off the right side. Nowhere close. And here comes North Texas on the far side from right to left. Ball up top here to Jones. Jones guarded by Flagg, now favoring the left wing as Sam Houston double-teaming. Scroggins trying to reach in on it. Jones able to get it away. Ball goes over to the right corner, now down low to Usman on the right baseline. He'll go back up top. Finds his teammate, Scroggins, blocking foul. Boy, Ken Scroggins is standing there as J.J. Murray ran right into him. And they're going to say that one was on Kian Scroggins, though. And that's his third personal and the third team foul for Sam Houston.
That's his third personal foul.
Third team foul for Sam Houston here in the second half. UNT will inbound, leading by 11. 37-26, 17:58 to go in the second. Bearcats still looking for their first points. Kian Scroggins steals it on the inbound, throws it behind his back, and here comes Jaden Ray to the right side. Yes! Good for Jaden Ray as Kian Scroggins made that one happen. Lampley hauled it in and fed it up to Jaden Ray. So that'll get the Bearcats on the board here in the second half. It is a 9-point UNT lead, 37-28, 17:30 to go in the second. As Perry went inside, almost got it stripped, and now the ball bouncing around. Down to 9 on the shot clock here for Perry as he'll go inside. Javion May had a hand up in it, and somehow Perry threw up a prayer, and it was answered as it fell through the bottom of the net. 39-29, UNT back by 11 here. 17-12 to go in the second. Bearcats have it moving from left to right. It is Jaden Ray. He turned it, boy, just threw it right in the hands of Reuben Jones. Jones one-on-one flag, flip it up under the right arm of Savion Flag, and that's an easy layup. 41-28, turnovers leading to points here for North Texas. As Ray will bring it across the timeline from left to right. He is guarded here by Murray. Ray, drop pass over to Lampley. Lampley almost turned it over, and luckily Javion May was able to skate his way forward and haul that one down. 10 on the shot clock for Jaden Ray from the free throw line. He'll backpedal Savion Flag. Flag wanting to drive in, takes up a jumper with a hand in his face, and that shot is good. Reuben Jones was all over him, and Savion Flag able to make that jumper from about 15. We'll step aside on a media timeout. Bearcats trailing 41-30, 16:32 to go here in the second half. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
Back at it here from the Super Pit in Denton, Texas, on the campus of North Texas. I'm Rob Hipp. Thanks for joining us for Sam Houston Men's Basketball on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network. Sam Houston trailing by 11, Bean Green leading 41-30. Sam Houston, their woes from the three-point line tonight, 0 of 13. After the previous game at UTSA where the Bearcats went 15 of 35, they have not been able to make anything from downtown, and that's really been the difference so far here in this game. Sam Houston got to find a way. They have jacked up 10 more shots from the field from UNT, and they've made the same amount of shots, 14 apiece. But Sam Houston only shooting 36% while UNT at 48%. The difference right now, again, those three-pointers, is UNT is 5 of 15 from downtown. Sam Houston also missing free throws, 2 of 6 from the charity stripe. They have turned it over 12 times. The Bearcats have scored 12 points, though, off of 10 UNT turnovers. Sam Houston out-rebounding UNT 27-20 so far here in this ballgame. I want to remind you, if you're out there watching on our In the Booth feed, send us a message. Let us know you're listening tonight. And if you're listening on the radio, we'd love to hear from you. 512-522-9105. Again, that's the Bearcat fan text line. 512-522-9105. Our good friend Justin Green saying, well, let's go. Eat 'em up, cats, on that Bearcat fan text line. And also our good friend Rhonda Ellisor cheering on the Bearcats. Dave Richardson saying, nice run to get back in this one. He was talking about to end that first half. And also our good friend Ronnie Snow, thank you for joining us tonight in the booth. We get back into action here. North Texas will inbound. They'll move from right to left again, leading 41-30, 16:27 to go here in the second. As the Mean Greens, Perry has it from right to left on the near side. Double team by Javion May and Jaden Ray. Pass goes over to the right wing, McBride. McBride going down to the corner to Murray. Murray, boy, he slipped there. There was no travel call. He finds Bell in the left corner. Bell wanting to drive in. And a blocking foul called here on Javion May. So for May, that is his second personal foul and the fourth team foul by Sam Houston here in 4 minutes of play to start this second half. As Nicholas will check back in, Javion May will head over to the bench for Sam Houston. He's got 4 points in 14 minutes. Nicholas 0 for 2. He's played in 10 minutes so far in this game, and at the line shooting free throws here is Thomas Bell. They're going to say he was in the act of shooting. Bell, a 77% free throw shooter. He is 2 for 4 here tonight on his home court. He'll bend his knees. The delivery on the way. This one bounces off the front and then drops out. So the first free throw is missed here by Bell, a 6'5" senior forward. One of the leading scorers on the team, averages 13 a game, but only 4 here so far tonight. Here's the next free throw from the left hand. This one no good either, and Flagg was able to hold on to it as it bounced off his right shoulder. He'll go over to Jaden Ray. The guard brings it into the front court, right-handed dribble, now swings it over his left shoulder to Flagg. Flagg drop off to Lampley on the left wing, now over to the right wing. It is Jaden Ray. Ray almost lost his handle, able to hold on to it. Over to the baseline, Lampley, left side, not there. Scroggins, though, to clean it up. How about that for Kian Scroggins? I think Lampley was ready to slam that one down with authority and got a hand on it. Scroggins was there, though. It's 41-32. UNT with the lead, 15:30 to go here in the game. Bell has it from the left elbow. Flag guarding him. He'll retreat down to the second key on the left side. Trying to work a turnaround jumper from the paint with a hand in his face. What a shot there by Bell. Boy, Savion Flag had great defense, but Bell was able to take the one-on-one and award it for his efforts. 43-32, Bearcats trailing. 15 minutes to go here in this game. Jaden Ray over the left wing. Lampley for three. This one an air ball. He may have got hit on his right arm and there was no call, and it goes out of bounds off of Nichols. And Sam Houston turns it over. Boy, tough there for the Bearcats. That'll take us to another media timeout. 43-32, 15:04 to go here at the Super Pit. We'll step aside on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest, conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville. The Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
What's up, good evening, friends. Welcome back. Rob Hipp here from Denton, Texas at the Super Pit UNT Coliseum. Sam Houston men's basketball trailing the Mean Green 43-32, 15:04 to go in this contest. As UNT has made three of their last three shots, they've led by as many as 20. Whenever you go back to the 15:25 mark, that was their last lead actually here in this one, but they led by as many as 20 when it was 23-3 to open up this game. Bearcats actually led 2-0, and then it was a 20-0 run by UNT. Sam Houston clawed their way back in, down by as many as 20. They came back, got it to within 5. It's been stretched back to 11 though. For UNT, trying to make it 14 home wins in a row. Just like at Bowers, it's tough to play here at the Coliseum. Maya Simmons into the ballgame now. He will inbound this ball on the baseline on the right side for UNT. As we'll get back into action here on the court for North Texas is Bell, Perry, Simmons, Murray, and Jones. Here come the Mean Green. It is Perry on the near side from right to left, guarded by Ray. Works around a high screen on the right wing by Bell. Now the pass over to Murray. He'll take a three. This one dead duck off the left back of the rim. No good. Bearcats chance to bring it back to within single digits here. Jaden Ray has it in the front court. Way up there, top of the three-point line. Kian Scroggins sets the high screen. Ray rolls. Lampley thought about a three. Now he'll take it. Lampley. Oh, man, it rolled in and out. Scroggins, though, fighting for the rebound and drops it, and it goes right back into the hands of Perry. Perry, he wants to work. This one partially blocked, but it goes right over to Murray. Murray from the corner. Pass around the world to Jones. And now into the hands of Perry on the right wing. Plenty of time on the shot clock here. Nicholas guarding him. Perry will zing it over to Murray. Left corner. Rattles in. And no, it will not drop. And the ball goes out of bounds off of Sam Houston. Savion Flagg was down there, and a hard rebound goes off his fingertips. So 20 back on the clock here for UNT. We got 14 minutes to go, and the Mean Green leading 43-32. Jaden Ray will head over to the bench alongside DeMarcus Lampley. Jaron Cook checks in for the first time tonight. And Dante Powers back in there for Sam Houston. It is Flagg, Cook, Nicholas, Powers, and Scroggins on the court for Sam Houston. UNT inbounds, McBride over to Perry on that left wing. Dante Powers, a reach-in foul there on Powers. He's kind of questioning that call, but it was obvious reach-in there on Powers, and that's his third personal. And the 15th foul by Sam Houston. Perry will inbound here on his own baseline on the left side. Goes over to Usman. Usman backing down Scroggins. Turnaround jumper not there. This one into the air, and Flagg able to save it. Goes up to the far side. Nicholas. Nicholas over to Jaron Cook from the right wing. Let's see if Cook can nail a three. Cook guarded by Usman goes down to Scroggins. Scroggins out there on the right wing. Back up top over to Flagg to the left wing. Dante Powers. Powers trying to work it on McBride. He'll drive inside. Floats this one up for a miracle, and it's good off the left side of the glass. I don't think Powers meant for that one to go in, but he'll take it. It's 43-34, Mean Green by 9, 13:27 to go here in the game. UNT will bring it into the front court on the far side from right to left. It is Perry. Jaron Cook has a hand on his face. Perry works over to the top of the three. Now to Bell on the right wing. Actually, I believe that's Usman. No, it is Bell. Bell trying to back down. Eight on the shot clock. Here's a three-pointer from the left wing. That shot won't fall for Jones. And a whistle and a flag here against the Mean Green. The foul there is on Usman. That is his second personal and only the second team foul of the second half. 13 minutes to go. Sam Houston trails 43-34. As Perry will head over to the bench for UNT. Bearcats will bring it into the front court. It's Dante Powers crossing the timeline at center court. Right-handed dribble to the right wing. Handoff over to Nicholas. Now over to Savion Flagg on the left wing. Jaron Cook. He'll go down. Here's a turnaround jumper. Nicholas. This shot won't fall on the rebound by Usman. There's a good look from about 13 near that left wing. Just wouldn't fall. Here's Jones. Jones over the corner. Down low. Good pass to Usman down there. Usman guarded by Scroggins. Turnaround floater. Good. We made that one look too easy. It's a 6'10" forward against a 6'7" freshman, Kian Scroggins. Savion Flagg, he'll take a three right wing. Yes, finally one falls from downtown for the Bearcats. It's Savion Flagg, raise the flag. And after the Bearcats went 0-15, they finally get a three-pointer to fall. 45-37, 12 minutes to go. Sam Houston trailing as Flagg pops it away. It's a turnover. Savion has it on the right side. Over to Dante Powers at the top of the three. Working a dribble into his right hand. Rotates to the right wing. Guarded by Usman. High screen coming here by Scroggins. Now over to Nicholas. Down low, Scroggins. That one turned over. Keehan didn't get separation. Turned over. Here comes UNT. Bell for three. Left wing. No. Off the front of the rim. Usman is the ball. Ping pong its way around. Goes back to UNT. A three-pointer no good. And the rebound here. Scroggins up top to Powers. It is flag again from downtown. Yes! Back-to-back threes. Raise the flag, baby. And the Bearcats coming alive here in the second. The Bearcats needed to find something from downtown. They have pulled it back to within five, trailing 45-40. 11:22 to go here in the game. We'll step aside for 90 seconds from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Hey y'all, Josh Ward here for Bilfick Ford in Huntsville. If you want a real truck that looks good and that can pull any load, do what I did. Decide the options you want and go see No Bull Bill. You'll spec out your order and agree on pricing, and then leave the rest up to Bilfick Ford. You trust them to build the Ford truck of your dreams, and they'll trust you to buy it. No deposit required, and you still get a No Bull deal. It's buying made easy. Bilfick Ford, your No Bull headquarters. Check them out online, BilfickFordHuntsville.com.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
Back at it, friends. Bearcats on a... Savion entering this game right at his season average of 19. He's played in 8 of the 9 games so far. And we'll get back into it here from the super pit. Again, 45-40, Bearcats trailing by 5. Sam Houston trying to find some life here and keep this running. North Texas, by the way, they've only made one of their last 7 shots. Fairly large school up here in Denton. Close to 40,000 enrolled, 22,000 students at Sam Houston. And a fair crowd here made their way to the super pit. Here comes UNT bringing it into the front court on the near side from right to left. Ball carrier is Perry at the top, guarded by Powers. As the Bearcats slip, now flag guarding it. Perry has it. Bounce pass off the right hand, goes over to Jones, back to Perry. Now wants to weave inside traffic, picks up his dribble as he's double teamed. Turnover! Turnover as Nicholas was down there and pulled it in. Bearcats with the turnover, trying to expand on this 6-0 lead. Dante Powers on the right wing. Jaron Cook, he's trying to feed Ipe. Bearcats able to hold on to it. It was almost turned over. Here's a floater by Nicholas. This shot won't fall, and a rebound there on the offense, on the defensive side by Mark Des McBride. Here comes UNT on the far side. Straight away is Bell. He'll hop step his way inside. Now a pass to McBride for three from the corner. It's not there. And Savion Flagg hauls in his ninth rebound of the afternoon. He's close to a double-double. Here comes Dante Powers for three. Off the left side, it won't fall, but Nicholas with the rebound. Powers over to Savion Flagg from the right wing. He'll jack up another three. It's not there. And a whistle and a flag is called. And we'll see if it was in the act of shooting. Savion Flagg wants three free throws. I don't know if he's going to get it. And the foul there was on Usman. It's his third personal and the third team foul. Actually, five team fouls now. No, it was a third team foul. They will say it was in the act of shooting. So Savion Flagg to the line here for free throws coming up. Flag one for one. He's only a 37% free throw shooter. Here's the first one. This one no good. Got to make them. Got to make those free throws. That's something that he's been working on. 45-40, 10-11 to go here in the game. Sam Houston trailing by five. Flag, another free throw. And another miss. Marcus Lampley will check in for Jaron Cook. He'll get a high five from the bench. Marcus Lampley in there. Here's the next free throw. Savion's got to make this one. And he doesn't. It goes off the front. Misses all three of them. The Bearcats only 2 of 9 from free throw land here tonight. UNT has it back on the left side. Up to Bell at the top of the three. Goes down to Usman, who's starting to get a little foul trouble with three here. He'll drop this one off. Perry flips it up off the left side. It's actually Bell. That shot was no good. Great defense by Sam Houston. Flag over to Dante Powers on the right wing. Quickly back down to Flag, and we got a foul here against Usman. That's his fourth. Oh, he is not happy. And Usman, the leading scorer on the team for UNT with his fourth foul, and he will head over to the bench. Checking in for him is Jemiah Simmons. Usman not happy as coach down there is telling him, hey man, everything is all good. Coach McCaslin talking to him. Here's the Bearcats inbounding up top over to Ipe. From the right elbow, drops it off over to Powers. Powers wants to work in from the left side. Up off the glass, yes, good for Dante Powers. The Bearcats have pulled it to within three, trailing 45-42, 9:29 to go here in the game. UNT back on the left side, it's Perry. From the top of the three, guarded by Flagg, left-handed pass goes over to Bell. Bell wants to work from the circle. He'll flip up a shot. This one is good. Bell says, what you can do, I can do better. He answers the layup back the other side. It's back to a five-point lead. 47-42, Bearcats trailing, 9 minutes to go. Back on the right side, Powers over to Nicholas. Nicholas to Ipe, now to Lampley, left wing. Pass back over to Flagg. From the corner, he'll tack up a three. This one isn't there. And a box out by UNT on the far side. Here comes Jones from right to left. He'll find Bell. This one left side and one. And now UNT finding some light again. After it was pulled within 3 moments ago. And UNT at the line here. Two free throws or and one coming up, rather. 49-42. Powers now with his fourth personal foul and 16 fouls in this second half with 8:47 to go. So one more foul by the Bearcats will put UNT in a 1-1 bonus. As Powers will head over to the bench. And checking back in is Jaden Ray. At the line shooting the and one is Thomas Bell. He's in double digits now with 10 points, 2 of 4 from the charity stripe. This one off the front of the rim, and Ipe able to box it out. Ipe hauled it down over to Nicholas, and now it's Jaden Ray in the backcourt. He'll bring it into the front court across the timeline, right-handed dribble, right wing. Still has his dribble, rotates over to his left hand. Now the pass from his left hand over to Tristan Ipe at the top. Ipe chest pass to Lampley. Lampley with 10 seconds on the shot clock. He'll pick up his dribble, bounce down to Ipe. Ipe's got to work here, was down to six. He'll force his way, turnaround jumper, battles his way, and drops in for Tristan Ipe. Ipe now with 6 points in 19 minutes, 49-44. 5-point lead here for UNT. And Jones has it. The left side into the front court. Crossover dribble back to his right hand, back into his left hand. Davion May with the defense. Bell, though, found some separation. Quickly double teamed. He'll go up top here to Jones. And now right wing three. This shot will fall. Rebound. Knocked around. And, boy, the Bearcats can't hold on to it. He goes right back over to UNT. And it's into the hands of Perry here, who shot that last three on the miss. Down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. Perry. He'll drop this one down here to Usman. He's blocked by Ipe. 1-1. It's a bigger part of jump ball here, favoring Sam Houston, thanks to the fancy handwork of Tristan Ipe. That'll take us to another media timeout. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Bearcats trail 49-44 with 7:30 to go from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
COVID-19 rapid testing is available at Texpress Urgent Care in Huntsville. No symptoms needed. So now you can get tested even faster and get your results back faster too. Limited shots are left. Not sure which test is right for you? Texpress Urgent Care is happy to help. For more details, call 936-570-2626. No appointments needed. Walk-ins only. Texpress Urgent Care Clinic, located at 193 I-45 South. Check their website at TexpressUrgentCare.com and visit them on Facebook. That's Texpress Urgent Care, next to Sport Clips in Huntsville.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest, conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville. The Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Bearcat Volleyball serving up aces at Johnson Coliseum. Don't miss the excitement and action that's Bearcat Volleyball. Season tickets just $30 and single game matches are $5. Get your tickets today. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets.
Artech Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artech Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
49-44, Sam Houston men's basketball trailing on the road at North Texas here in the Super Pit. 7:32 to go. Bearcats have trailed by as many as 20 in this game, and they have found a couple of runs to pull to within five. A 20-point advantage, by the way, when it was 23-3 way back in the first half. Leading all Bearcats scores is Savion Flagg. He has a double-double tonight now with 19 points and 10 rebounds. However, only 2 of 10 from three-point land. He's 1 of 4 from the free throw line. The Bearcats, that has really been the Achilles heel of this team that has, well, been the spike in that hill, if you will, this season. It's the free throw shooting, where they are only shooting 55% and then 35% from downtown. But tonight, only 11% from three-point land, but they are 11% from three-point land, 2 of 19. Both of those coming, though, back-to-back by Savion Flagg. Here we go, back into it. Bearcats have it on the right side, trailing by 5. Jaden Ray, he'll find Ipe. Left side and 1, baby! Tristan Ipe to the rim, and it falls. Well, the Bearcats needed something. They got it there on the assist by Jaden Ray to Tristan Ipe. Ipe, a 62% free throw shooter. And an and one coming up here. On the right side is Ipe. Takes several dribbles. Bends his knees. The free throw shot. It is no good. Bell with the board. Coach Bailey calling for his team to quickly get back down there to the left side. Jones was all open for UNT, and Taylor Perry didn't see him. Here's UNT to the left side. Put up a shot here, and it's good off the right side of the glass by Jones. 51-46, 5-point deficit for Sam Houston, 6:56 to go. J. Jaden Ray has it on the right side. Trying to weave through traffic. Now he'll retreat back to the left wing. Over to Javion May. May from the right wing. Ipe was calling for it down there in the post, but he was quickly harassed by two defenders. Here comes Jaden Ray from the left baseline. He'll retreat with five on the clock. He's got to hurry here. Jaden Ray over to Flagg. They've got to put up a shot. Savion Flagg, he'll throw it up at the buzzer. He's fouled. He'll go to the line shooting two. Savion Flagg drew contact as the shot clock was running out. And a foul is called, and Savion Flagg to the line here to shoot two free throws. The foul was on Reuben Jones, his first personal. And for North Texas, that is their 16th foul. And we've got a timeout on the court. I believe the officials, they may be going over to review this one to see if that shot clock had in fact expired. We'll take a 30-second break during this official's review. Stay with us, friends. We'll be back in a moment from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcat Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
All right, so the play will stand. It was a foul against Jones, his first personal, 16th foul. And Savion Flagg to the line here for two very critical free throws. Bearcats back up to 40% from the field, 21 of 53. And Savion Flagg has got to hit these free throws. He's only one of four. Here's the first one. No good off the front of the rim. Boy, if the Bearcats can hit their free throws and hit some three-pointers, this team is not a 3-6 team. Here's the next free throw attempt. This one is good. So a big one there for Savion Flagg. Pulls it to within four. 51-47. 6:29 to go. Remember this UNT team with their current winning streak is holding opponents to 48 points. Bearcats are getting close to that now. Here's North Texas back on the left side. Trying to work a dribble down low. This one bounces around to Jones. Jones over to Bell. Bell with 9 seconds on the clock. Throws up. A miracle the shot's not there. It's poked around, and Lampley comes up with it. Lampley on the near side with a right-handed dribble. Back over to Jaden Ray. Ray crossing into the front court. He'll find Savion Flagg. Flagg wants it. He'll zip it over to Javion May, and it is a blocking foul against North Texas. As Flagg was looking in the direction of May, and with 17 fouls, that's one and one coming up here now for Sam Houston. The foul was called on Simmons. That was his second personal for Jemiah Simmons, and the seventh team foul. So here's Savion Flagg, one and one. Bearcats now in the bonus. They'll shoot the rest of the 5:55. Flagg takes the first one. No, it won't fall. Bell hauls it down. 5:50 to go here in the second. Bearcats trailing 51-47. The Mean Green have it from right to left. It's Perry at the top. He'll go to Bell. Bell trying to slam it down, and Tristan Ipe wasn't going to have it. A foul here against Ipe, and that is his fourth personal and the seventh team foul by the Bearcats. So Kian Scroggins will head over to the scorer's table. He'll check in here. And two free throws coming up for Thomas Bell. Bell, by the way, in double digits now with 10 points. He is 2 of 5 from the charity stripes. Team trail leading 51-47. Here's the first free throw on that left side. It's good at the bottom of the net. Ipe will head back over to the bench. Kian Scroggins checking in. Ipe, 8 points in 21 minutes of play. Here's the second free throw by Bell. Critical free throws here. Off the left hand, this one good as well. Back up to a 6-point advantage for North Texas, 53-47, 5:40 to go here in the second half. On the court for Sam Houston, it is Flagg, Lampley, Ray, Powers, and Scroggins. And for the Mean Green, McBride, Bell, Perry, Murray, and Jones. Ray brings it in the front court on the near side from left to right. On the right wing, high screen, Scroggins. Ray drops it off with the left hand over to Dante Powers. Powers rotates over. Right wing three. Well short. Off the front. But Ray not able to hold on the rebound. He just lost the handle and it goes to Perry. Here comes Perry here for UNT. He'll bounce it over the left wing to Jones. Now the baseline from the left corner is Bell, and he's fouled. Free throws coming up here for Bell and UNT. Ken Scroggins charged with his fourth personal.
San Houston State foul, number 40, Keon Scroggins. That is his fourth personal foul.
18 fouls, four personal for Keon Scroggins. He'll head back over to the bench, and Damon Nicholas.
Houston, number 10, Damon Nicholas Jr.
Onto the court now for Sam Houston. Free throws coming up here for Bell, who's got 12 points, 4 for 7 from the free throw line. On the 1-1, first one is good. One more coming up for Bell. Well, the Bearcats have gotten it so close, and they just have not been able to get over that hump here in the last few games and that they've lost. 54-47 here, trailing by 7. One more free throw coming up for Bell. Made the first one, second one, yes, good. 55-47, North Texas with the lead, 5:12 to go. Bearcats bring it into the front court. On that near side, down to the right side is Jaden Ray. The left-handed dribble picks it up over to Savion Flagg, top of the three. Flagg puts it on the court from the right elbow, right side. He's fouled. And we'll see if it was on the court, too, or in the act of shooting. Free throws coming up here for Savion Flagg. He's got to make them, though.
Big green foul number 15, Ruben Jones.
Foul is on Ruben Jones, his second personal, and the eighth team foul by UNT. Free throws coming up here for Savion Flagg. 2 of 7 from the free throw line. Here's the first one. No good. It was a 1-1. And the ball goes into the hands of Perry. Perry has it for UNT. Leading 55-47, under 5 minutes to go. Perry on the left wing, guarded by Jaden Ray, trying to fend him off with his left hand. Now switched up. Flagg guarding him. Perry backpedals down to 8 on the shot clock at the top of the three. He'll work it now on Savion Flagg. Flips this one up, and it's no good. It bounced around like a Plico chip on the Price is Right and fell off. And here's Jaden Ray. He'll find Powers. Powers up top to Savion Flagg. Boy, he went up really high in the air, and Savion Flagg goes down. He is grimacing there on his left knee, and a flag was called against UNT. The fans are not happy. And luckily, Savion Flagg gets up. Boy, I thought for a moment he may have hyperextended his knee. He went way up into the air. Saw it on the replay. That right knee kind of popped. The foul was called here on J.J. Murray, his second personal. 19 fouls and 1-1 coming up here for Savion Flagg. Fans not happy with that foul. Flagg has missed the free throws, though. Trying to make one here. This one rattles in and out. No good. 2 of 9. And the Bearcats are 3 of 15, 20% from free throw land. UNT has it leading 55-47, 4:10 to go here in the second. They've got it back on the left side. It is Thomas Bell. The right wing to Perry, and a reach-in foul called here on DeMarcus Lampley. It's his second personal. 19 fouls by Sam Houston. So 1-1 coming up here now for UNT. Shooting the free throw is Perry. He's 2 for 2. 4 points in 24 minutes for Perry, who normally averages 13 points a game. Perry will take a deep breath on that left side. Bends his knees. First free throw is good. He'll have one more coming up. That stretches it back to a 9-point UNT advantage. Haven't made a field goal, though, in 3 minutes. Bearcats haven't scored in 2.5 minutes. Perry will have one more free throw coming up. Bends his knees, right-handed free throw on its way. Good at the bottom of the net. And it's back to a 10-point UNT advantage. Bearcats have got to find a way to score here. Jaden Ray has it on the right side. Nicholas out there with him in the backcourt and the frontcourt now. Jaden Ray trying to fend off the defender. He'll flip it over to Nicholas, right side, good. Oh, baby, laser vision focus by Jaden Ray on the assist to a striking Nicholas down low. And after almost 3 minutes, the Bearcats finally scoring, trailing 57-49, 3:37 to go here in the second. As Bell has it on the left wing, guarded by Flagg. Trying to work inside here. Flagg now the switch off, Lampley guarding him. Bell backing his way down, 8 seconds on the clock from the baseline. Picks up his dribble. He'll slice it, dice it, slam it down to Perry. Well, every time the Bearkats have a nice play, UNT responds. There's Savion Flagg on the right wing. With Jaden Ray at the top of the three. Ray tries to work it from the free throw line. Turn on the Jets, Jaden Ray. How about it there for Jaden Ray? And that'll take us to a media timeout for 2 minutes. Bearkats trailing 59-51, 3:07 to go. Don't go anywhere, folks. We've got an exciting finish here on the Bearkats Sports Radio Network.
Fans on your feet.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearkat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats!
Enjoy the fast-paced action of Bearkat soccer at historic Pritchett Field. Tickets are $5. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearkats.com/tickets to secure your tickets today.
Welcome back, friends. 59-51. Bearkats trailing by 8. 3:07 to go here in men's basketball at UNT at the Super Pit. As we'll pause 10 seconds for station identification, this is the Bearkats Sports Radio Network.
1.7 KSAM is KSAM Huntsville, and you're listening to the Bearkat Sports Network.
Bearkats have made four of their last five shots. Time, though, not a friend to them right now, and it's been a shooting woes tonight from behind the arc. Bearkats only 2 of 20, and also from that charity stripe, 3 of 15 tonight. If you just make one or two more threes and make your free throws, Bearkats will be up front. That's been the way it is this season for Sam Houston. I talk about their record at 3-6, but really, besides one or two games, it was really stretched apart. Bearkats have been close. They lost 74-65 at Nebraska. They lost 72-59 versus Boston U, 75-66 at SMU, 73-57 at Texas, and then 78-73 at UTSA on Saturday night. Here comes UNT, under 3 minutes to go, holding on to the 8-point advantage from right to left. Into the hands of J.J. Murray, up top to Bell on that top of the 3-point line on the left side. Now Perry has it. From the right wing, he'll pass here. Goes down to Bell. He'll swing this one over. 6 on the shot clock as Murray will drive inside. Left baseline, good. Boy, he went up between two players for Sam Houston, Nicholas and Powers, and was able to skate through them and lay it up. 10-point advantage. Bearkats trailing, 2:28 to go. Lampley will float this. Actually, Jaden Ray will float it in from just outside the semicircle in the paint. That shot good for Jaden Ray. Bearkats have made 3 of their last 3 shots. Trailing here 61-53, 2 minutes to go. North Texas has it on the far side from right to left. It's Perry with the left-handed dribble. Crosses over to his right hand. Bounce pass to the left wing to Murray. He's guarded by Ray. Now the ball up top to Bell. Bell, the chest pass goes over to Perry with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Down to 8, down to 7. Perry still has it. He'll go from the left elbow, retreats back, takes a straightaway 3. No, he passes here. That's a shot clock violation. A 3-point shot fell by Bell, but it was too late, and a shot clock violation turns it over to the Bearkats. They're trailing by 8, 61-53, 1:45 to go here in the game. As it'll take us to a timeout, Sam Houston's going to take a 30-second break. We'll take it with him from Van Wagner. This is the Bearkats Sports Radio Network.
Artech Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artech Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
Back at it here. It was actually an official's timeout as they reviewed to make sure it was a shot clock violation, and it was. So the Bearkats will inbound here. Men's basketball trailing 61-53, 1:43 to go on the road here at North Texas. Sam Houston has it on the right side. Ray spins around, floats it up. This shot, no good. Murray with the rebound. Ray in this ballgame with 10 points, 5 of 9 from the field. He's been feeling it as of late, but missed that one. That's a critical miss. A good look, though. Perry has it. Now to the right wing, over to Murray. Murray goes around, left wing Perry for 3. Out shot, no good. Rebound, flag. Still some life here for the Bearkats, but they've got to score quickly. As flag has it, 1:10 to go. Step back, long three-pointer. This one well off the front. Nicholas with the rebound. Over to Dante Power, straightaway 3. That one won't fall. And the rebound hauled in with a minute to go here by UNT. It's been that kind of a night for Sam Houston from the three-point line. North Texas has it on the far side. Perry, and he's fouled here by Savion Flagg. So two free throws coming up. 10 team fouls now. You had to commit that foul. Savion Flagg with his first personal, and again, the 10th team foul. At the line here to shoot two free throws is Taylor Perry. Tyler Perry here from the free throw line. Perry, only 6 points, but 4 of them coming from the charity stripe, where he's 4 of 4 this evening. 61-53, his team by 8, 51 seconds to go. He'll bend his knees. The right-handed free throw shot is good. 5 of 5, perfect. North Texas, though, they've had their worries from the free throw line tonight. 15 of 24, they're only shooting 63%. Jaron Cook will come in, a three-point specialist for Sam Houston, as Nicholas will head over to the bench. So it is Flag, Cook, Lampley, Ray, and Powers for Sam Houston on the court. Here's the second free throw by Perry. This one good as well. McBride, Bell, Perry, Murray, and Jones. 10-point advantage for UNT. Sam Houston from left to right, Jaden Ray. Inside, bounce pass down low. Lampley floats it in and good for 2. Nice feed by Jaden Ray, with his third assist of the night. 35 seconds to go. UNT, Jaron Cook will foul him with 33 seconds to go. 63-55, and Perry back to the line here, where he is a perfect 6-for-6 so far this evening. Jaron Cook with his first personal. 2 free throws coming up here for UNT's Taylor Perry. Tyler Perry, rather. Perry taking his time, bends his knees, first free throw on the way, and he remains perfect, 7 of 7. Well, up next for Sam Houston, they'll return home to host Hardin-Simmons at 2 o'clock. That on the 18th, the Saturday game. Please come out to Johnson and support these guys. Here's the next free throw. Both of those are good. They love nothing more than to see a packed house at Johnson Coliseum. And I know that that would fire these guys up as well. Here are the Bearkats on the right side. Jaden Ray over to Dante Powers. 2-pointer from the left corner is no good. Rebound here, and UNT should be able to run the clock out. But Sam Houston got close. They trailed by as many as 20. They fought their way back. They got it down to within 4 late in the second. But for a second consecutive game, they were not able to hold on. And the Bearkats will drop another contest here, their second in a row. And they are now 3-7 on this season. 65-55, your final tonight. 14 in a row at home for the Mean Green. We'll step aside and take a break. We'll have postgame coming up. Stay with us, friends. This is the Bearkats Sports Radio Network. Again, with this
win, everyone receives... Bearkat Volleyball serving up aces at Johnson Coliseum. Don't miss the excitement and action that's Bearkat Volleyball. Season tickets just $30 and single game matches are $5. Get your tickets today. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearkats.com/tickets.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep. Along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Enjoy the fast-paced action of Bearcats soccer at historic Pritchett Field. Tickets are $5. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets to secure your tickets today.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Season tickets are on sale for 2021-22 basketball season. Season tickets start as low as $99. One price gets you both men's and women's Bearcat basketball. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets to secure your seat today.
Hey, y'all, it's Aaron Watson. Need a new vehicle? It may only be a swipe away. Every time you swipe your First Financial Bank Visa debit card between now and the end of February, you will be automatically entered into a drawing to win a new vehicle of your choice. Swipe often, and you will soon be driving up and down that honky-tonk highway. For promotion rules and a list of participating dealers, visit ffin.com/sweepstakes. No purchase necessary. Member FDIC.
101.7 KSAM and the Bearcat Sports Network present the Bearcat Basketball Post Game Show. Now for an in-depth analysis of tonight's game, let's return courtside with Rob Hipp.
Welcome back, friends. Post game, Sam Houston men's basketball falls on the road tonight versus the Mean Green at the Super Pit here in Denton, Texas, 65-55. As I said earlier, Bearcats trailed by as many as 20 when it was 23-3 early in the first. And in the second half, went on a run. They pulled it within 4 points, but for a second consecutive game, not able to find the advantage. A lot of it, again, because of the poor shooting tonight. We just have to call it how it is. Unfortunately, the Bearcats, 2 of 22 from three-point land at 9%. The only two free throws were from Savion Flagg. We'll quickly go over final team stats. Bearcats shot 25 of 62 from the field at 40%. As I just said, 2 of 22 from three-point land. Only 3 of 15 from that charity stripe as well. Bearcats doing a fair job, only turning it over 13 times. 14 points off of 14 UNT turnovers. Sam Houston once again out-rebounding their opponent, 41-37, 26 on the defensive side, 15 offensive boards. Sam Houston had 8 second chance points, 10 off the bench, 42 down in the paint. They had 15 fast break points, no blocks tonight, 12 steals as Sam Houston bringing some pressure in this game. They had a nice night stealing and 9 assists. They did not lead in this ball game. Well, they did lead, actually. They led 2-0 early for only 1 minute and 33 seconds. For UNT, they shot 21 of 48, 44% from the field, 5 of 23 from downtown at 22%, 18 of 27 from free throw land at 67%. They turned it over 14 times. They scored 14 points off of 13 Bearcat turnovers, 37 rebounds, 29 on the defensive glass, and 8 offensive rebounds. UNT had 7 second chance points, 10 off the bench, 32 down in the paint, 7 fast break points. They had a block, 11 steals, and 10 assists. Again, UNT taking control in this one and holding on for a 10-point advantage, 65-55. There were 4 players in double digits for the Mean Green tonight. Leading all scorers was Bell with 14, 4 of 10 in 34 minutes. Again, 14 points. Usman had 13 points in this ballgame, 5 of 8 from the field in 20 minutes. McBride had 12 in 37 minutes, and then Perry had 10 points in 28 minutes. He was only 1 of 5 from the field, but a perfect 8 of 8 from the free throw line. For Sam Houston, we talk so much about other players needing to step up. It can't be Savion Flagg every night. Unfortunately, in this ballgame, no different than some of the others. Savion Flagg, 8 of 19 from the field. He was only 2 of 11, though, from three-point land, 2 of 9 from the free throw line. He had 11 rebounds, 1 foul, 2 turnovers in 37 minutes. Savion Flagg with a double-double tonight with 20 points. The second scorer for Sam Houston, Jaden Ray, 5 of 9 from the field. He was 0 of 1 from downtown, 2 rebounds, 3 assists, 3 turnovers and 31 points. It was 10 points for Jaden Ray. Behind him, Tristan Ipe, 4 of 7 with 8 points in 21 minutes. Dante Powers finishing up this ballgame with 6 points, 3 of 8 in 21 minutes. May, Lampley, Scroggins, and Nicholas Jr. also getting on the board tonight. So once again, Sam Houston falls here on the road 65-55. And the Bearcats will try to rebound things again, hosting Hardin-Simmons at 2 o'clock on Saturday. Well, friends, this broadcast has been authorized under rights granted by Sam Houston to Van Wagner. The accounts and descriptions of this broadcast may not be retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of Van Wagner and Sam Houston Athletics. The executive producers of Sam Houston Basketball is Zach Kaditz. The coordinating producer, Desiree Chambers, and a special thanks to the Sam Houston Athletic Communications Office, Jason Barfield, Ben Reichard, and Cody Stark. This game also made possible in part by our good friends at HEB. HEB, no store does more than my HEB. Studio operations possible by K-Sam. I want to thank Carlos Zimmerman back at the flagship studios tonight. Once again, tune in for the next broadcast on Saturday, 2 p.m., hosting Hardin-Simmons at Johnson Coliseum. Come out and support the Bearcats. Friends, one final time, I'm Rob Hipp, reminding you tonight that we're not strong enough alone to make it on our own. We need each other. Provide a word of encouragement. Lend a hand of support. Somebody out there tonight needs you. Good night, and God bless from Denton, Texas. We'll see you, friends.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Season tickets are on sale for 2021-22 basketball season. Season tickets start as low as $99. One price gets you both men's and women's Bearcat basketball. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets to secure your seat today.
You've been listening to Sam Houston State University Bearcat Basketball. No portion of this game may be rebroadcast without express written consent from Sam Houston State University, our broadcast partners, or 101.7 KSAM. We are the Bearcat Sports Network.